Ever wondered how decentralized exchanges process trades and discover prices? Unlike traditional exchanges, a DEX uses an automated market maker, AMM, to enable a fluid trading system that borders on autonomy, liquidity, and automation. First of all, what is market making? As its name implies, market making connotates the process involved in defining the prices of assets and simultaneously providing liquidity to the market. In other words, a market maker does create liquidity for a financial asset. It must find a way of meeting the selling and buying request of traders, which in turn plays into the pricing of said asset. For instance, a Bitcoin exchange uses an order book and an order matching system to facilitate Bitcoin trades. Here, the order book records and showcases the prices at which traders desire to buy or sell Bitcoin. The order matching system, on the other hand, matches and settles sell and buy orders. At every given time, the most recent price at which Bitcoin was bought will automatically feature as the market price of the digital asset. In some cases where there are not enough counterparties to trade with, the market is said to be illiquid or prone to slippage. Slippage occurs when the processing of large order volumes drives the prices of an asset up or down. To mitigate this occurrence, some crypto exchanges employ the services of professional traders, in the form of brokers, banks, and other institutional investors, to continuously provide liquidity. These liquidity providers ensure that there are always counterparties to trade with by providing bid-ask orders that would match the orders of traders. The process involved in providing liquidity is what we call market making, and those entities that deliver liquidity are market makers. Now that you understand what market making is, it's a bit easier to grasp the workings of an automated market maker. And what are automated market makers? Unlike centralized exchanges, decentralized trading protocols do away with order books, order matching systems, and financial entities acting as market makers. Some examples are Uniswap, Sushi, Curve, and Balancer. The goal is to eliminate the input of third parties so that users can execute trades directly from their personal wallets. Hence, a majority of the processes are executed and governed by smart contracts. In other words, AMMs allow traders to interact with smart contracts programmed to enable liquidity and discover prices. How do AMMs work? First and foremost, have it at the back of your mind that AMMs use preset mathematical formulas to discover and maintain the prices of paired cryptocurrencies. Also, note that AMMs allow anyone to provide liquidity for paired assets. The protocol allows anyone to become a liquidity provider, or LP. To explain this further, let's take Uniswap as a case study. The protocol uses the popular X times Y equals K equation, where X denotes the value of asset A, and Y represents that of asset B. K is a constant value. Hence, regardless of changes in the value of asset A or B, their product must always be equal to a constant. Note that the equation highlighted as an example is just one of the existing formulas used to balance AMMs. Balancer uses a more complex formula that allows its protocol to bundle up to 8 tokens in a single pool. While there are a variety of approaches to AMMs as exemplified by Uniswap and Balancer, the fact remains that they require liquidity to function properly and negate slippages. As such, these protocols incentivize liquidity providers by offering them a share of the commission generated by liquidity pools and governance tokens. In other words, you get to receive transaction fees when you provide capital for running liquidity pools. Once you stake your fund, you will receive liquidity provider tokens that denote your share of the liquidity deposited in a pool. These tokens also make you eligible to receive transaction fees as a passive income. You may deposit these tokens on other protocols that accept them for more yield farming opportunities. And to withdraw your liquidity from the pool, you would have to turn in your LP tokens. Impairment loss. Although AMMs offer significant returns to LPs, there are risks involved. The most common is impairment loss. This phenomenon arises when the price ratio of assets in a liquidity pool changes. LPs who have deposited funds in affected pools automatically incur an impairment loss. The larger the shift in the price ratio, the larger the loss. However, this loss is called impairment for a reason. As long as you do not withdraw deposited tokens at a time that the pool is experiencing a shift in price ratio, it is still possible to mitigate the loss. The loss disappears when the prices of the tokens revert to the original value at which they were deposited. Those who withdraw funds before the prices revert suffer permanent losses. Nonetheless, it is possible for the income received via transaction fees to cover such losses. Over the past couple of years, AMMs have proven to be innovative systems for enabling decentralized exchanges.